Good morning, Cardinals fans. Welcome back to About Last Night. So, about last night. Christian Yelich is a name I'd imagine Mike Schilt is not going to miss seeing in the opposing lineup for a while. Dude is some kind of locked in after hitting homers in all four games of the opening series. I definitely said Paul Goldschmidt was a cheat code, and then Christian Yelich happened. What's a cheat code of a cheat code? Because that's Christian Yelich. But I have to say, if I hear the Cardinals should have had him instead of Ozuna every game this season, I'm going to lose my mind. To me, there is nothing that matters any less right now than a decision that the Cardinals and the Marlins made two off-seasons ago. It is going to be exhausting if we have to hear about what could have been in every Yelich at-bat for the rest of forever, considering it's already making me a little twitchy. Christian Yelich is a Brewer, not a Cardinal, and he pretty much single-handedly won them 3 games out of 4 on opening weekend. Period. Case closed. End of story. But I digress. In other news, Michael Wacha's first start since June 20th of last season got off to a shaky start with the Yelich bomb, and then he settled in and kept the Brewers just enough off balance to keep putting up zeros. 5 of them, to be exact. And that 6-inning outing was huge after short starts in each of the first 3 games. Meanwhile, it took the Cardinals until the 4th inning to figure out how to not swing at Corbin Burns' slider off the plate. The first 9 outs of the game came via the strikeout, and the only base runners were the 2 lefties in the lineup, Matt Carpenter and Colton Wong. Yes, Jeff Albert, please? No, it's fine, I'll leave a message. I thought you were fixing this. Spoiler alert, he did. Ish? Or Paul DeJong did. After Marcel negative launch angle base hits Ozuna, eked out an infield single, a fastball from Burns to DeJong stayed up, and I'm not sure it ever came down. And after looking completely helpless for 3 innings, the Cardinals were suddenly on top. Baseball, am I right? In the 5th, Carpenter and Goldschmidt went back-to-back to straightaway center, and that had everyone wearing red feeling mighty fine for a minute. Sort of. Double-digit strikeouts by Cardinals hitters in all 4 of the season opening games is concerning on another level, but that's a problem for another day. Once again, the bad news was Andrew Miller and Jordan Hicks and Christian Yelich again. And in the 1 game of the series where the starting pitcher played his part, the relief corps did anything but. Although Marcell Ozuna's perplexing defensive contributions shouldn't be ignored here either. Baseball, am I right? Good luck writing that recap, Stu. You can find it at birdsontheblack.com. Look, we knew from the start that this series would set a tone, and so far, the tone it set isn't a pleasant one. At least for Cardinals fans. But if you want the glass half full take, the Cardinals matched the Brewers pretty much slug for slug. They were just really overpowered by Josh Hader and Christian Yelich. But the reality is, it takes one pitch to change everything, and the Cardinals could have won 3 instead of lost 3. It was that close. And that is the story of the Cardinals losing 5-4 on a walk-off double and dropping the season's first series 1 game. To 3. There's trouble in paradise already. Be sure you hit subscribe and turn on the notifications because misery loves company or something. Check out the Pirates series preview that is up now. The Cardinals are in Pittsburgh for a weird 2-game set, and today is the first look at Adam Wainwright's 2019 campaign. I really, really need it to go well. I'll see you then.